Hello guys, welcome to another wonderful session of Learning Mathematics with Prep Class. I am BC, I am a Prep Class tutor. In this video, we are going to be solving Loyola Jesuit College Entrance Examination Mathematics Paper 3 from questions 31 to questions 35. Subscribe to our channel. Also, make sure you like and comment on our videos. Thank you. So let's move on to the first question in this video, question 31. What is the smallest number that can be divided exactly by 12, 7, and 4? So this is very easy. What is the smallest number that can be divided exactly by 12, 7, and 4? So the smallest number that can be divided exactly by 12, 7, and 4 is the LCM of the numbers. So this is the same thing as asking you to find the LCM of 12, 7, and 4. Remember, LCM can be calculated using different methods. You have the prime factorization method, you have the listing multiples method. In this video, we're going to be using the prime factorization method. The first step is to express each of the numbers as a product of its prime factors. So 12 is 2 times 2 times 3. These are the prime factors that make up 12. 2 times 2 times 3. 7 is 1 times 7. 7 is already a prime number, so it's just 1 times 7. 4 is 2 times 2. So the prime factors of 4 is 2 times 2. Now, the next thing is to multiply the prime factors, but write the common factors once. So these are the prime factors. 2 times 2 times 3 times 7. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 3 is 12. 12 times 7 is 84. Therefore, 84 is the smallest number that can be divided exactly by 12, 7, and 4. So this is very easy. Whenever you are asked to solve a question like this, just know that it's an LCM question. So you are just to calculate the LCM. Okay, so the LCM of 12, 7, and 4 is 84. So the correct option is A, 84. So 84 is the smallest number that can be divided exactly by 12, 7, and 4. Number 32, evaluate 14 whole number 2 over 3 plus 23 whole number 6 over 7 plus 18 whole number 4 over 5. So these are fractions, but so many students think that fractions are very difficult. They are actually very easy. They are not difficult at all. Okay, so let's do this using the following steps and then you'll get your answer easily. And then you wouldn't find it so difficult anymore as well. All right, so these fractions are mixed fractions. What are mixed fractions? Mixed fractions are fractions that have the whole number part and the fraction part. Okay, so this fraction can be expressed as 14 plus 2 third plus 23 plus 6 sevenths plus 18 plus 4 fifths. Okay, so now we have written it as the whole number and the fraction part. So the whole number is 14, the fraction is 2 thirds. The whole number is 23, the fraction is 6 sevenths. The whole number is 18, the fraction is 4 fifths. So we've expressed it as a whole number and fraction. Okay, now the first thing is to separate the whole numbers from the fraction. So the whole numbers here have 14, 23, and 18. So we add them here. 14 plus 23 plus 18 plus you add the fractions as well. So we have 2 thirds plus 6 sevenths plus 4 fifths. Okay, so 14 plus 23 plus 18 can be done here. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 plus 8 is 15. Write 5, carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 plus 2 is 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. So 14 plus 23 plus 18 is 55 plus the fraction 2 third plus 6 sevenths plus 4 fifths. Okay, so 2 third, 6 sevenths, and 4 fifths are unlike fractions. What do I mean by unlike fractions? Unlike fractions are fractions that do not have the same denominator. So the denominator here is 3, the denominator here is 7, the denominator here is 5. So they are not the same. So for us to be able to add these fractions, we need to find a common denominator. A common denominator can be obtained by finding the LCM of the denominator. So LCM means lowest common multiple. We found LCM in the first question in this video, so it's still the same method we use for this one as well. So, using the prime factorization method, express each of the denominators as a product of its prime factors. So the denominators are 3, 7, and 5. So let's express these denominators as a product of their prime factors. So 3, 7, 5. The prime factors of 3 are 1 and 3. So 3 is already a prime number. So that is why it's 1 times 3. Then 7 is also a prime number. So it is 1 times 7. 5 is a prime number. So it is 1 times 5. So the prime factors of 5 is 1 times 5. So we've been able to express each of the denominator as the product of their prime factors. Now the next thing is to multiply the prime factors, but make sure that you write the common factors only once. So we have 1 times 3 times 7 times 5. 1 times 3 is 3. 3 times 7 is 21. 21 times 5 is 105. Now that we have found the LCM, we have to convert the denominator of each fraction to the LCM. So let's do that now. So we have 2/3, we have 6/7, and we have 4/5. So now we want to convert each of the fractions to have a denominator of 105. So 3 times what number will give us 105? 3 times 35 is 105. So we multiply 35 by the numerator as well. So 2 multiplied by 35 is 70. The second fraction is 6/7. So let's convert this to have a denominator of 105. 7 multiplied by what number would give 105? 7 multiplied by 15 would give 105. So we also multiply the numerator by 15. 6 multiplied by 15 is 90. Then this is the third fraction, 4/5. So we want to convert this to have a denominator of 105. So 5 multiplied by what number would give 105? So 5 multiplied by 21 would give 105. Then we also multiply 4 by 21. 4 multiplied by 21 is 84. So now 2/3 plus 6/7 plus 4/5 equals 70/105 plus 90/105 plus 84/105. So now you can see that they are like fractions now. They all have the same denominator. So the denominator is now 105. So now that they are like fractions, we can add the numerators and divide by the common denominator. So the numerators are 70, 90, and 84. So 70 plus 90 plus 84 divided by the common denominator, which is 105. 70 plus 90 is 160. 160 plus 84 is 244. So 244 divided by 105. So now the next thing is to convert the mixed fraction by dividing the numerator by the denominator, then write as quotient remainder divided by denominator. So let's do that here. 244 divided by 105 is 2. 2 times 105 is 210. Then let's subtract 210 from 244. 4 minus 0 is 4. 4 minus 1 is 3. 2 minus 2 is 0. So we do not write it. So we have 34. 34 is the remainder. Y2 is the quotient. So let's express 244/105 as a mixed fraction. So we have two whole number, 34/105. Remember, this is the number we had. 54 plus 2/3 plus 6/7 plus 4/5. So 55 plus fraction. What we got when we added these fractions was two whole number, 34/105. So let's add it to 55. So we can add the whole numbers. 55 plus 2 plus 34/105. 55 plus 2 is 57. So now we have 57 whole number, 34/105. So you can see this is very easy. So which of the options is correct? B is the correct option. 57 whole number, 34/105. Check. Number 33. An item was bought for 3,155 naira and later sold at a profit of 63%. How much was it sold? Okay, so this is very interesting. The first thing we have to do is to bring out the information in this question. So an item was bought for 3,155 naira. So that is the cost price. The cost price is the amount the item was bought. So it is 3,155 naira and later sold at a profit of 63%. So the percentage profit is 63%. How much was it sold? So we are asked to find the selling price. The selling price is the amount an item is sold. Selling price is given as cost price plus profit. but we don't know the profit. So this means to get the selling price, we need to find out what the profit is first. Profit is giving us percentage profit multiplied by cost price divided by 100. The percentage profit is 63%. The cost price is 3,155 naira. So let's multiply 63% by 3,155 naira divided by 100. 63 multiplied by 3,155 naira would give us 198,765 naira divided by 100. Then, when you divide 198,765 by 100, you get 1,987 naira 65 kobo. So now we have gotten the profit. So we can go ahead and find the selling price now. Selling price is cost price plus profit. The cost price is 3,155 naira, and then the profit is 1,987 naira 65 kobo. So let's add this together. We'll have 5,142 naira 65 kobo. So the selling price is 5,142 naira. So the correct option is D, 5,142. That is the amount the item was sold. Okay, check. Number 34. Evaluate 30 whole number 2 third minus 8 whole number 5 sixth. So this is very easy as well. So these are mixed fractions. 30 whole number 2 over 3 and 8 whole number 5 over 6 are mixed fractions. So let's convert these mixed fractions to improper fractions. And this is done by multiplying the whole number by the denominator, then you add it to the numerator and divide by denominator. So let's do each of the fractions here. So the first fraction is 30 whole number 2 over 3. So whole number multiplied by denominator plus numerator divided by denominator. So we have 30 times 3 plus 2 divided by 3. 30 times 3 is 90. 90 plus 2 is 92. So we have 92 divided by 3 as the first fraction. Then the second fraction is 8 whole number 5 over 6. Now let's convert this to an improper fraction. So we have 8 times 6 plus 5 over 6. 8 times 6 is 48. 48 plus 5 is 53 over 6. So we have gotten the second fraction as well. We've been able to convert the two mixed fractions to improper fractions. So we have 32 whole number 2 over 3 minus 8 whole number 5 over 6 to be 92 over 3 minus 53 over 6. So these fractions are unlike fractions. So this means that they do not have the same denominator. So we have to find a common denominator by obtaining the LCM. LCM means lowest common multiple. So we are going to be using the prime factorization method. The first thing to do is to express each of the denominators as a product of its prime factors. So the prime factors of 3 are 1 and 3. The prime factors of 6 are 1, 2, and 3. So 1 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 will give us 6. So now that we have done this, we multiply the prime factors, but we write the common factors once. So when we do that, we have 1 times 2 times 3, which will give us 6. So we've been able to find the LCM of 3 and 6. The LCM of 3 and 6 is 6. So now we convert the denominator of each fraction to the LCM. So we have 92 over 3. We want to convert this to have a denominator of 6. So what do we multiply by 3 to get 6? We multiply 3 by 2 to get 6. We must also multiply the numerator by the same number. So 92 multiplied by 2 is 184. So this fraction is now 184 over 6. Then the second fraction, 53 over 6. So this already has a denominator of 6. So we can just multiply it by 1. 6 multiplied by 1 is 6. 53 multiplied by 1 is 53. So now we have 92 over 3 minus 53 over 6 to give us 184 over 6 minus 53 over 6. Now that they have the same denominator, we can now add the numerator and divide by the common denominator. 184 minus 53 divided by 6. 184 minus 53 is 131. So we have 131 divided by 6. Now, we are not through with the question because we have to convert it back to mixed fractions. How do we convert to a mixed fraction? We do this by dividing the numerator by the denominator, then write as quotient remainder over denominator. So 131 divided by 6, we can do that here. 13 divided by 6 is 2. 2 times 6 is 12. 13 minus 12 is 1. Then bring down the next digit, which is 1. So you now have 11. 11 divided by 6 is 1. 1 times 6 is 6. 11 minus 6 is 5. So now we have the quotient to be 21, and the remainder is 5. So 131 divided by 6 is 21 whole number 5 over 6. So we have been able to solve this question. So 30 whole number 2 over 3 minus 8 whole number 5 over 6 is 21 whole number 5 over 6. So the correct option is D, 21 whole number 5 over 6. Now, question 35. A trader bought an item for 8,332 naira and sold it for 37,577 naira 32 kobo. What is his percentage profit? So this is actually very easy as well. So let's get out the information in this question. A trader bought an item for 8,332 naira. So this is the cost price. The cost price is the amount the item was got. So that is 8,332 naira. And sold it for 37,577 naira 32 kobo. So this is the selling price. The amount the item was sold is called the selling price. So the selling price is 37,577 naira 32 kobo. Then what is his percentage profit? To find the percentage profit, we need to know the profit. Profit is given by the formula selling price minus cost price. The selling price is 37,577 naira 32 kobo minus the cost price, which is 8,332 naira. We can do that here. 2 minus 0 is 2, 3 minus 0 is 3, 7 minus 2 is 5, 7 minus 3 is 4, 5 minus 3 is 2, 7 minus 8 is not possible. So we get 1 from 3 and it remains 2. Then we put the 1 here, this becomes 17. 8. 17 minus 8 is 9. Then 2 minus nothing is 2. So we now have 29,245 naira 32 kobo. So this is the profit. Now let's find the percentage profit. Percentage profit is profit over cost price multiplied by 100. The profit is 29,245 naira 32 kobo divided by the cost price, which is 8,332 naira multiplied by 100. 29,245 naira 32 kobo multiplied by 100 is 2,924,532. So now let's divide it by 8,332. Naira cancels naira. So now we have 2,924,532 divided by 8,332. So we can do that here using the long division method. 29,245 divided by 8,332 is 3. 3 multiplied by 8,332 is 24,996. So let's subtract 24,996 from 29,245. 5 minus 6 is not possible, so we get 1 from 4 and it remains 3. We put the 1 here, it becomes 15. 15 minus 6 is 9. Then 3 minus 9 is not possible, so we get 1 from the next digit, which is 2. This becomes 1. We put the 1 here, and then this is 13. 13 minus 9 is 4. Then 1 minus 9 is not possible, so we get 1 from the next digit, and this becomes 8. We put the 1 here, and this becomes 11. 11 minus 9 is 2. 8 minus 4 is 4. 2 minus 2 is 0, so we don't write it. So now we have 4,249, which is not divisible by 8,332. So we bring down the next digit, which is 3. So this is now 42,493. 42,493 divided by 8,332 is 5. 5 multiplied by 8,332 is 41,660. So let's subtract 41,660 from 42,493. 3 minus 0 is 3. 9 minus 6 is 3. 4 minus 6 is not possible, so we get 1 from 2 and it remains 1. We put the 1 here and it becomes 14. 14 minus 6 is 8. So we now have 833. So we have to bring down the next digit, which is 2, and this becomes 8,332. 8,332 divided by 8,332 is 1. 1 × 8,332 = 8,332. 8,322 subtracted from 8,332 is 0. So now we've been able to completely divide 2,924,532 by 8,332. So the answer is 351%. So the percentage profit of this trader is 351%. So which of the option is correct? The correct option is B, 351.0. So the percentage profit of this trader is 351.0%. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video and you're able to learn a lot. Please subscribe to our channel, like and comment on these videos, as I'll be happy to respond to your comments in the comment section. You can also join us on WhatsApp by clicking on the link in the description below. Till I come your way next time, bye for now.